Hey everyone, it's Mike Ball from WordPress.com, and we've been looking at full site editing. This is a suite of new tools that came out in WordPress 5.9, and they basically give you superpowers when it comes to editing every aspect of your site. So we've been looking at how to navigate around, how to use the new tools in different ways, but what we haven't been able to dive into yet and what we've been getting a lot of questions about is what to do with them. Aside from making your site very pretty or very beautiful and making it look exactly the way you want, how do you use it in a practical way? So we're going to look at a couple different sites and a couple different use cases, specifically at templates and template parts and how they can save you time and kind of give you a little bit of a extra superpower in doing some of these things. So let me shrink my face down and we'll open up my screen. So right now I have the editor open. It defaults to the home page. So what we're going to do first is go up into your site icon. Might be look like a W for WordPress, or if you have a icon loaded in, it'll be there, and then it'll give you options. So get the site, the templates, or the template parts. So for this purpose or this exercise, we're going to look at templates specifically, and we're going to jump into the single post. Now, editing this post basically changes how every single blog post you write will look. You'll see right now it doesn't look like much, but if I actually open this list view, there's a ton of blocks in here, and these populate dynamically based on what kind of content you wrote in your post. So if we look a little bit closer, we have the title. That's all the header stuff. We're not going to mess with the header right now, so I'm just going to collapse that. We come down here, we have the post title, featured image, that separator underneath, a spacer, and then the actual body content. So this site is about an animal called a pangolin. They're the most trafficked mammal on the planet, I found out as I was putting this together. So let's say we're trying to raise money for pangolins specifically. Now, I could create a reusable block and then add that to every post as I'm creating them. That's one extra step that I have to remember. It's still pretty easy, but it's not as easy as this is going to be. So what I'm going to say is maybe under this featured image, and maybe under that, well, we can move it around. Let's say under the featured image, we're going to add a CTA. Instead of choosing a specific block right now, I'm actually going to take a shortcut and I'm going to click this browse all button and I'm going to actually click on the patterns option. Now this is going to actually bring a lot of different kind of block combinations that other people have created or that have been created for specific use cases up on your screen so you can take a look at them. You can drill down, if you look at this little drop down menu, by what kind of block pattern you're looking for. So in this case, if I want to drive people to donate, I'm probably looking for this call to action option. I'm going to go ahead and click that and see what we come up with. And as I'm kind of scrolling through, I have to remember I'm looking for something that's going to appear under the featured image. So I probably don't want another big image. That might be a little bit too much. I'm probably looking for something a little more simple. And let's see if this can do it. So you see the second I click on it, I get that drop directly into what I'm working on right now, which is pretty cool. I'm going to switch back over to this list view, and we're going to go down here and see what all blocks came with that kind of pattern. So you see it's within a layout grid. It's got some column groups that are in here. It's got a heading, ultimately some paragraph text, some buttons, and they're all kind of spaced out with different settings. So one thing I'm going to look at overall first is just the settings on the layout grid. And as we're doing this, I think what I'm going to do is shrink my face and move it back over here so it's out of the way. So if we're looking at these settings on the right side, we have how many columns there are. We have gutter size, which is how much is on either side. We can kind of play with that if we want. Doesn't really do a lot. So that's probably not what I'm looking for in here. The easiest thing to start with probably is really just getting into this background. And so when I click on that, you'll see the settings on the side changed and I have my colors right away. So I'm going to go in here and I'm going to look at my color palette at the bottom. And I'm not sure if any of those are quite right, but I did spot there's this peach color up here. And I think that looks pretty good. Then for the text option, since it's not selected right now, it should default to the global styles that I have set, but I'm going to look at my options in here. Again, I have my custom color palette. Green looks okay, but it's a little hard to read, so I think I'm going to go with blue or purple. Purple looks nice. And I can do the same thing with my donation button if I really want to, just to make it match. I'm going to choose that purple again. And I can change how big or small I want it, how much padding exists around the different sides, what kind of border I want. I kind of like it rounded. And then maybe I want to reduce some of the spacing or make it a little bit wider. It's probably too wide. Let's say 75%. Okay, so it's looking pretty good. It's still a little tall overall. One trick I'll show you all is when you have these options, this little padding window, this circle shows you which side you're editing when you're editing it. And padding is basically blank space. So when I say padding, I'm really talking about how much blank space exists basically in between this and the top of this block. So if I change that 96 to a 20, I would expect it to get short. And then if I click on the far right side or here, and you'll see I'm trying to get the bottom spacing, and that little black bar shows up. I'm going to try to change that to 20 as well. And actually, that does not look as good as I thought it would. Let's go back to 50. And that looks pretty good. We can also go to the blocks that exist within there and play around a little bit if you really want to, but for today, we're going to move on. So now I have a nice CTA that's going to show up under the featured image of every single post that I create. I've still got this separator and a little space before the post content starts. And then I've got kind of what just came in this template already. I haven't edited those things yet. But that was pretty easy, so I can save that.